Hello, all you beautiful and amazing crypto fanatics out there. My name is Colin. This is Colin Talks Crypto. How do we know when to take profits when we're getting close to the bull run top? In fact, how do we even know we're getting close? Well, I've created a tool, the CBBI. You've probably heard me talk about this before, the Colin Talks Crypto Bitcoin Bull Run Index. And I am very excited to announce we have added a slew of new features to make this even more useful for taking profits toward the bull run peak. cbbi.info is where you can find the Colin Talks Crypto Bitcoin Bull Run Index. And that's what you're looking at on your screen right here. As of July 9th, 2021, we have a CBBI confidence score, confidence that we're approaching the bull run peak of 54. And basically, the CBBI is an index, which is an indicator based on a portfolio of metrics. And we have 11 different metrics down here. I'm not going to belabor them because we've covered these in many previous videos. But what I am going to show you in this video is all the different features and functionality that we have added recently that you're probably not aware of. So first of all, the major feature addition is we have toggleable metrics. We actually have the ability to toggle individual metrics on and off. And if you look at the bottom of your screen here, you can actually see that there's little blue checkboxes underneath each and every single of the 11 metrics. Essentially, you are now able to click and deselect or select any of these as you wish, and it will update the chart based on what you want to see. So if you only want to see one metric, you can actually deselect all these extra ones and just look at the Bitcoin Trololo trend line as the CBBI interprets this particular metric. Or let's take a look at the Puel multiple. This is what the Puel multiple looks like as interpreted by CBBI. Let's say, for example, you want to look at Puel multiple and the Ruple and the Trololo trendline charts. All those three, but not the rest of the other eight. This is what that customizable index looks like. So you can now customize the CBBI to suit whatever metrics you want to look at. And we did that to offer you your own ability to take a look at this how you wish. Some people don't agree with including the Bitcoin search term. Obviously, I agree with using all of these because that's why they're here and I created this index. But I don't expect to enforce my opinion on you. And so that way you can select what you want and you can cut out the Bitcoin search term if you don't like it. And this is what it looks like when you remove that one metric. You can see the slight change it makes on the CBBI. And we'll go through some of these other charts a little more in depth, but I also want to show you some other functionality we've added. So there's the zoom feature, which will quickly zoom you to whatever time frame is shown here. Here's 6 years, here's 3 years, here's the whole chart. But you can also type in a specific start date or end date by just typing it in this text box right here in the top right corner. Additionally, we have recently added all these different toggle switches down here, and I'll introduce you to them one by one. So first of all, we have the Bitcoin price. Notice that you can disable any of these that you wish. Next, we have the CBBI confidence score, as reflected by the active checkboxes above. So if you unselect some of these, it reflects it back through the entire Bitcoin history instantaneously. Next, we have added the block halving, the Bitcoin halving event. And that's what each of these three vertical lines are that you see on your screen right here. If you put your mouse over any of these, it brings it to the front so you can see just that particular item. So right here are the Bitcoin halving events. Next, we have the Bitcoin price peaks for every cycle, indicated by this high, and the Bitcoin price lows for every Bitcoin cycle, indicated by this red low. So right now on your screen, you see everything that this feature-rich display has to show. We have the Bitcoin price, we have the CBBI, we have the Bitcoin halving event, we have the price peak and the price bottom for every Bitcoin cycle. And you can customize this to any time frame you want. And this was made possible by a new charting library. Again, props to Camille Monish for finding this and implementing this. It loads faster and it's more flexible. Allows all this functionality. We additionally made an improvement to the website load time. Previously, it was loading about 1.2 megabytes of data, and that has been cut down to 250 kilobytes, just under a quarter of the size that it was before. And that was made possible due to compression. So now the data is being sent to your web browser or your device in compressed format, and then uncompressed on your device very quickly, so it loads even faster than before. Also, you'll notice if you refresh the page, there is a loading symbol that appears while it is loading that information, just so you're not left wondering what is happening while it's processing that information. Because keep in mind, we are loading the last 10 years of Bitcoin data here in customizable format so that you can update it and change it in real time. So I think these changes are incredible. It's more responsive, it's smoother, and it's customizable. I'm going to take you through each one of these charts individually so we can take a look at how it is interpreted by the CBBI. But before I do that, I want to just plug a few things here. We do have a brand new CBBI Daily Twitter bot, and this shows you the CBBI confidence score exactly like you see it here. This is one of the tweets. One time per day, it will post this to your Twitter feed, and then you can be updated without even having to go to the website. So I encourage you, if you haven't already, please do follow the CBBI underscore daily Twitter bot. And as I've said, we've added Litecoin and Cardano, as well as EOS, Binance Coin, Ethereum, Bitcoin Cash, Bitcoin, BTC as donation addresses. If you feel that our hard work is worth something, please do consider sending a donation our way. Camille and myself split it 50-50 right down the middle, and we really do appreciate your donations. It has been much appreciated and actually encourages us to do things like you see right here. So keep those donations flowing and we'll keep the updates happening. I want to show you the projects and articles page right here. And you can see that we have the official sites right here, the official CBBI Twitter bot, the official GitHub, the official website that you just saw, as well as community created projects, of which we have quite a few. It's really been very flattering to see all the community projects springing up behind the CBBI. So right now we've got a community created Telegram channel right here at this link. We've got an Android mobile phone app that shows you the CBBI score. And we've got two iOS, iPhone, or iPad mobile apps that show you the CBBI confidence score on a daily basis, as well as the individual metrics. And so please support these community projects because they support us as well. We're also keeping a list of all the articles that mention or review the CBBI, and they're right down here. You see we've been covered by Bitcoin.com, DailyCoin.com, and Medium.com, CoinMonks. And if you know of an article that we haven't featured here, especially a prominent one, please do send it our way. We don't have eyes all over the entire internet, so we might miss something. So if you send it to us, we can check it out and we'll put it on this page right here. And the same goes for any phone apps, Android, iOS, Telegram, Twitter, you name it, anything community created, we are happy to share on this page. We'll take a look at it. If it meets our standards, it'll go on this page right here. But do keep in mind that the stuff that we create is the stuff that we officially stand behind. And these things down here are really subject to change at any time because we didn't make these ourselves. But we love the community involvement nonetheless. I do want to show you how it looks when you change this chart by removing metrics. You can see that as you unselect them, it actually dramatically changes the visualization of the chart. And some of them are a little surprising. And what you're seeing here with this blue line is the exact way that the CBBI software interprets these metrics. So if you're ever curious how CBBI looks at Rupple slash Nupple, show me your Nupples, this is exactly how it looks at it in terms of 100% at the top and zero at the bottom. This is how it's contributing to that overall average of 54 up here. Some of these are time-based linear metrics in that they progress evenly through time. So that's why something like the golden 51-49 ratio and the stock to flow chart are actually linear charts. But that's two of the 11. So let's look at the other ones. Here's the Bitcoin search term. And if you remember, not too long ago, we optimized this so that it was a little less sharp and a little more useful on a bigger time frame. So there's a more gradual ramp up to the peaks here with the Bitcoin search term. The Pi cycle top indicator is an interesting one. You can see that recently we did peak out on the Pi cycle top, but like I've covered before, right here in 2013, we also peaked at the sub peak. And you can clearly see that here's the 2013 actual peak. Here's the sub peak of that double top. And I strongly believe that this is a sub peak before we hit the actual peak later this year. And I back that up with the fact that all these other metrics pretty much agree with the fact that this is not the bull run peak. But if you disagree with me or you don't like the Pi cycle top indicator, then just deselect it and it will show everything but that. Next up, we have the 2-year moving average. And you can see here how the CBBI interprets this. This is a pretty good one. It's pretty clear as to where there's a peak. Actually, I'm gonna jump to my favorite one right now. Of all these metrics, now that they're broken out individually, it's actually even easier for me to understand how they are contributing to the CBBI. It just really helps when you have a visual format of something. So let's jump over to the R-HODL ratio. I think that I have to give this my number one pick of approval. The number one Colin Talks Crypto seal of approval for Bitcoin metrics goes to R-HODL ratio. Because look how much it didn't falsely call the sub peak in 2013, and look how crisp and clear the actual peaks are for the Bitcoin price. And if we toggle on the price high right here, you can see that it does call the Bitcoin price peaks exactly each time. And also, it backs up the fact that we did not just see the Bitcoin peak in this current bull run, because we saw a R-HODL ratio score of like 75 or 71. The highest it got was 75. It did not hit 80, it didn't hit 90, it didn't hit 100. I would consider above a 90 on the CBBI worthy of taking profits. That's just my personal take on this whole thing. And so if you have something like 74 or 75, it's not quite there yet. And this is one of many metrics that backs up the fact that this is not the peak. Just like back in 2013 when we had a 68 on the R-HODL ratio. We didn't go that much higher this time. So let's go back through some of these other ones. We have the two-year moving average, and you can see it right here. We have the Bitcoin Trololo trend line. That one's a little more steep, a little more sharp, but it also somewhat calls that false peak, that sub peak, but not too bad. This is another really good metric in my opinion. It doesn't call that sub peak with too much intensity, but it does show it on the chart. Let's take a look at the Rupple slash Nupple chart. As always, show me your Nupples. And you can see that, unfortunately, on the Nupple chart, it actually does show some Nupples right here. It's got the 2013 sub peak, which is showing 100 on the chart, just like it showed the actual peak. And you can see that the actual 2017 Bitcoin price peaks right here. And you can see that we also perhaps falsely called the price peak for the $64,000 Bitcoin price. Because again, just like in 2013, this could be calling a sub peak of a double top. But I do like this metric because it adds just another way of looking at this. You know, you don't want to bias your view too much. And so that's why we are looking at 11 different metrics. And here's the Puel multiple metric as indicated by the CBBI. So actually when it says here CBBI confidence score, in this case, it's just the Puel multiple confidence score as interpreted by the CBBI backend software. And you can see how we interpret it right here. There's two questions I want to spend a quick moment answering here that come up fairly often. The first of which is, can CBBI be used for indicating the bear market bottoms? This is the start of the bull run, which starts at the bear market bottom. So you can determine where the bottom is just as well as where the peak is. And we've actually optimized this recently, again, shout out to Camille, to make this more bear market friendly so that the bear markets are more clear than before. And we will continue to work on this, but right now we're focused on the bull market. But I just wanted to let you guys know that the CBBI is meant to be useful for determining both the bull market peaks as well as the bear market bottoms. It is useful for both ends of the spectrum equally. So this is why I'm going to be using the CBBI not only to take profits at the top, but to also re-enter the market perhaps several years later when the CBBI goes below 10 or so. And the other most commonly asked question is, can we use this for altcoins? Can we use this for the overall cryptocurrency market cap? What about making a custom Ethereum CBBI or a custom Cardano CBBI or insert your coin here, custom CBBI? I get that question so often. And the answer is a couple of things here. Bitcoin is the market mover. Bitcoin is the dominant market force. Cryptocurrencies generally follow Bitcoin because Bitcoin has the most market cap. And until that changes, I'm probably not going to create another CBBI for other coins. If someday Ethereum becomes number one, I may consider creating a CEBI. Colin Talks Crypto Ethereum Bull Run Index, and so on. But until that day happens, it's not really worth doing because of several reasons. There aren't as many well-known, well-established, and long-standing metrics that have proven themselves for other cryptocurrencies, especially the smaller market cap ones. You just don't have that kind of support for something like Cardano or EOS or Bitcoin Cash. They've been around for all of 4 years, and so you can't plot those with the same reliability as you can with Bitcoin, not to mention the fact that they also have smaller market caps. So right now we focus on the big kahuna because the big kahuna currently, Bitcoin, moves the market and dominates all the other cryptocurrencies. It doesn't mean you can't look at the other charts if you want to, but I just don't think it makes sense to make an index for other cryptocurrencies when they don't have such a vast array of reliable metrics and that don't go back as far and that don't have as much market cap. However, as it says right here, as the overall crypto market generally follows Bitcoin, as we just covered, the CBBI can be used as a macro leading indicator for other cryptocurrencies. And I say this because other cryptocurrencies generally follow later the moves that Bitcoin makes. If you've been around for a while, you know that altcoin cycles generally happen later than Bitcoin cycles. And so while this isn't a BNB or an ETH or a BCH specific chart, or insert your favorite coin chart, you can use this chart as a macro leading indicator to know when the big moves are going to happen, and likely when the big moves for your coin are going to happen, maybe weeks later or maybe months later, as the altcoin market typically does. So yes, this can be used for altcoins. It can be used to give you clues about when your altcoin is likely going to have some big macro movement. And that's how I'm going to be using this. All right, guys, I think I've packed this video with enough things. You can play around with this yourself. I think I missed a couple of these last metrics here. Please feel free to go through and look at each of these by yourself and understand how the CBBI confidence score is made. Play with all the customizable features of this. And if you like what Camille and myself have done, please drop us a donation in the area below. If you can't send a donation, then the next best thing is share this. Share this in an article, share this in a video if you're a YouTuber, share this on social media, share this with your friends and your family. I would love to just get this out there. So I hope you've appreciated what we've done. And with that being said, I wish you a blessed day.